like sheep without a shepherd. Today, this is Jesus' assessment as he stares out upon the great crowds of people hurrying to be with him and the disciples. They were like sheep without a shepherd. In her pastoral care course at United Lutheran Seminary, Dr. Storm Swain tries to impress upon her students the nature of sheep and shepherding. She grew up in New Zealand and is deeply familiar with shepherding's realities. Her concern is that our modern American understanding of shepherding has become quite sanitized. If our images of sheep are those from childhood rhymes, visualizations of pristine, woolly white sheep elegantly jumping over the moon, or adorable baby lamb play toys, we might miss the point of Jesus' comment today in our gospel. Sheep can get quite dirty. Their wool is often coated with hay and burrs and other bits and pieces from the fields, and it will continue to grow unchecked, causing mobility issues unless they are routinely sheared. And contrary to popular opinion, sheep are not stupid animals. However, they are quite skittish, timid, easily scared. They tend to bunch up with one another and can be difficult to move about, or they will keep a flight distance between one another and suddenly split, running in different directions if startled. Therefore, shepherding is a challenging, hot, sweaty, exhaustingly messy job. Sheep without a shepherd equals chaos, a disorderliness and sometimes tumultuous mess. It's no surprise then that Jesus tells the returning disciples, go away to a deserted place and rest a while. These newly minted 12 have been sent, traveling and proclaiming the good news, casting out demons and healing the sick. They have been acting as God's hands in this world, caring for Christ's sheep. So much so that they have been unable to even find time to eat. One can imagine them limping back to report to Jesus, hot, sweaty, exhausted. As they recount all that they have done with glassy eyes and growling stomachs, Jesus offers them away to a deserted place, all by yourselves, and rest a while. Jesus cares for the caregivers. Caring for God's children can be challenging. Whether you're nurturing babies and in the thick of midnight feedings and constant diaper changes, or rearing children juggling daily homework with meal prep and endless laundry, or mentoring teenagers and young adults amid the complexities of our current world, or accompanying partners, friends, brothers, sisters, aging parents, grandparents, and neighbors through all of life's passages. Caring for one another is a hot, sweaty, tiringly messy business. Caregiving requires long hours, and often the financial and emotional impact and commitment can be intense. Whether you are caring for someone physically, mentally, emotionally, or spiritually, today we are reminded Jesus cares for the caregivers. Come away and rest, he says. It would have been easy for the disciples to have dismissed Jesus Christ outright with a, no, 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 it's okay, we've got this, we don't need to rest, let's just keep going. After all, the crowds were hurrying after them, their needs were great, and we're only in chapter 6. These disciples have just gotten started. These disciples have just gotten started, and they already need a break. Whether it is a rare act of wisdom on the disciples' behalf, doubtful, or perhaps more likely, because they are just too plain tired to stand, and wordlessly wondering what they have just gotten themselves into, climb into a boat and head to a deserted place. I wonder, though, how often do we, as caregivers, obey Jesus' command to rest? Do we prefer to just keep plowing ahead, limping through our day-to-day schedules, juggling the needs of those around us? Do we heed Christ's command to come away to a deserted place? Or wait till we're completely depleted, huddling up together, unable to move, or anxiously distancing ourselves from others with an increasingly scattered mentality? We are all sheep in need of a shepherd. Perhaps it is our own skittishness or fearful tendencies that get in the way of us obeying Jesus Christ's command to rest. Yet we know sheep without a shepherd equals chaos. When we fail to heed our shepherd's command to rest, we become disorganized, muddled, a holy mess. We become like sheep without a shepherd. Richard Lesher writes, "The act of trusting is itself a replenishing activity. Like loving or farming or writing, you can't hold back your best for another occasion. If you give of yourself fully, there will always be more to give. Trusting makes for greater trust, not disillusionment of timidity." Jesus is preparing his disciples for a lifetime of ministry. Therefore, after they have given of themselves fully, he sends them away for rest, turns to the great crowds, and offers compassion. Jesus Christ calls us to give of ourselves fully to the work of caring for one another, and commands us to rest. It is the Good Shepherd who provides for both caregiver and care seeker, offering compassionate respite and sustenance for the journey together. The voice of today's psalmist is a powerful reminder of trusting in this way of Jesus Christ. Often it is heard as a voice of comfort to the sorrowful, or recited as like a poetic talisman to ward off fear. Yet perhaps we can also hear today in the psalmist's words a voice of bold, radical trust, spoken by a very tired sheep of Christ's flock. Pause and listen to Nan Merrill's interpretation of this cherished psalm. Let the words wash over you. Oh, my beloved, you are my shepherd. I shall not want. You bring me to green pastures for rest and lead me beside still waters, renewing my spirit. You restore my soul. You lead me in the path of goodness to follow love's way. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow and of death, I am not afraid, for you are ever with me. Your rod and your staff, they guide me. They give me strength and comfort. You prepare a table before me in the presence of all my fears. You bless me with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy will follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the heart of the beloved forever. Jesus Christ sends his disciples out into the world to serve. And when we report back to Christ, whether every Sunday in worship or every day in prayer, Jesus commands us to rest so that we may give of ourselves fully to his work again. There will always be more caring, more healing, more feeding. Next week, we will get a further glimpse of the extent of God's expansive divine providence through the story of the feeding of the 5,000. We are each Christ's sheep, both caregiver and care seeker. Our Good Shepherd offers us beloved flock, compassionate care, commands us to rest, calling us to serve, and in doing so, ordering our lives in his peace. We are no longer sheep